Social media. Void Interactive understands the importance of having a positive social media presence and keeping all our channels active and updated. Boy, do you know it. To this end, we tried to provide regular updates and videos regarding our progress.
So that was a fucking lie.
As I'm reading this statement, I'm thinking, all right, Void, you're saying this now, but I need to see this. I need to actually see you guys keep your word, you know? So I'm going to refer to this when you guys aren't doing anything. Not to be an asshole, but just to keep you in check. I want to see you guys keep your word. Don't disappoint me, Void.
What's up, everybody? Drew right back at it again with another video on Ready or Not. It has been a while since I talked about this game, and that's simply because they just aren't that active. They haven't really been talking that publicly about what they've been up to or what they're working on. I mean, to be fair, they've been more active in the alpha, but I can't really talk about that because there's a heavy NDA that's preventing me from talking about it, and they just have that really under wraps. It just really sucks because I can't talk about my bread and butter content. Like, I made a gamble with buying the supporter edition because I heard that they were going to allow content creators to show off and talk about the alpha, but ultimately I lost that gamble because they did the switcheroo and said that nobody can talk about it. They're no longer working with content creators or people from GameSpot or IGN, so I can't really give my perspective on things that's going on in the alpha. Like, the only thing that I'm able to do is really talk about things that are going on with their social medias, which there has been something that is recent, and I'll get to that in just a little bit. But I kind of just want to talk about the last time that they had actually updated anything, because it really has been a while since they've done anything, really, on their social medias. Let's start with their Facebook, because this is a site that I use the least. I only use it for family reasons, but since Void's here, I generally take a look. So the last time that the Ready or Not account was updated was on October of 22nd, which is a common theme that you'll see with all of these accounts, because it's been a while since anything's been done there. Over on their Instagram, the last time that anything was posted about Ready or Not was about a month and a half ago. Their main website really hasn't seen any updates aside from the FAQ button being added, which is actually really helpful for anybody that has any questions. But if anybody has any, like, questions, go and check that out, because it's really in-depth. But yeah, aside from that, nothing too significant. On their YouTube, the last thing that was posted was devblog 4, which was 2 months ago, and that is that. Moving over to the Reddit, there just hasn't been any posts from the official developers on Reddit in a very, very long time. I was actually talking with some of the people that go on there frequently, and they said that they haven't responded to people in a bit either. Skitch sent me some logs of the last time anyone from Void Interactive commented, and the last one was 3 months ago from Ryro. Anything else has just been a bot posting about their Twitter, which is a segue into their Twitter. Twitter is fairly active, with them commenting on something or them retweeting something relating to their game, which I guess is cool, but it's not about updates about the game itself. Any updates that have come out about the game thus far on their Twitter feels like something that really shouldn't be an update or public release, because it really only applies to people who have the alpha. To give an example, there was a tweet that was posted about a day ago, kind of explaining what's been going on with the alpha. Well, not really explaining, but like, what's kind of been going on recently. The tweet itself talks about a PvP event that was hosted in the alpha back on the 7th of December. Clicking the link that's provided here, it shows the dates and times of when the next couple of PvP events are going to take place. Now, just by reading the first paragraph, you can already tell that this is an older update, because it says this: the first event will be held this November 23rd across two time windows with a 1 hour interval, implying that this update was given out before the tweet that it was posted on, which is December 6th, but only in the alpha. It shows the dates and times and has a couple of cool little pictures here in there about red versus blue teams, and that's really about it. Like, this is only helpful to people who own the alpha, and by this point we've already seen it. I mean, most likely the reason they posted this was because maybe they thought that people didn't see the ping in the private Discord, so they went public with this post. But this doesn't really help someone who's trying to look for more information about their game. This is just really puzzling to me, because the last couple of newsletters were really only for the alpha supporters and not really for anyone who's an onlooker. Now, maybe I'm just overreacting. I've always known that Ready or Not's PR has been pretty shit, but I did a giveaway for Postscriptum a little while ago, and I asked one question that said, have you played Ready or Not? And shockingly, out of the 100 comments that I got, there was only one person that said that they own the alpha. The rest were waiting for gameplay updates, or just didn't want to fork out $120, or whatever it is in your currency. I know that my audience is small, but this kind of makes those public tweets of the closed alpha null to anyone who's looking for information about what the devs are doing or development of the game or anything of the sort. Again, I can't talk about the alpha. I can't say whether it's good or bad or what my experience was or what's in it because of this NDA. So then I tried relying on the updates from their social medias, but there's literally next to none in terms of updates. You know, I shouldn't even be surprised at this point. This is just something that's like a recurring theme with Void Interactive. You know, saying that they're going to do something and then they don't do it.
Like, I feel like a broken record at this point, just like, you know, complaining about the same goddamn thing.
I mean, with this recent tweet, I could say that there's PvP events going on, and maybe say that they have some modes that were featured on their Twitter, like Tug of War and Firefight, but there's really nothing else. That's all I got. Oh boy, this is going to be a very long trudge for the next 6 months until the beta. Hope more updates come out soon, but I'm gonna have to find some other content. You know, I just really hope that they hit that June beta mark. I mean, wouldn't that be awkward if they decided to delay that? You know, without telling us in advance? Cause that's never been done before. No. Not Void Interactive. Fight me if you think otherwise. I mean, I'd like to think that Void is on track to get things done, but when they go quiet, it can be really deafening. I'm just saying. So what are your thoughts on this update? I hesitate to really call this an update because it's kind of old news. But I mean, I guess it's new for somebody that just looked at their Twitter. So yeah. If you're someone that enjoys my content, be sure to like and share. If you're someone that's new, subscribe and ding the bell. If you really want to support my channel, check out my Patreon. Just send me $2 a month. And with that all being said, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.